We were able to put a lot of little Easter eggs that felt very fun.
I almost can't keep up with how many amazing little Easter eggs there are in this film.
Miles lives in an alternate universe, so there are little things that are different all the time.
You can't have a Spider-Man film without spider eggs.
As far as Easter egg spiders go, I'm quite partial to Scarlet Spider.
Ben Reilly has that sort of classic 90s look.
He has like too many triceps.
So many muscles.
Is he okay?
Ah!
I really love Web Slinger.
Bombastic Bagman.
Here's the Insomniac Spider-Man from the PlayStation game.
Another video game guy.
Are you talking to me?
It's rude to stare.
Spider-Woman Canada in the original Summit Series hockey jersey, which is a very prideful point in Canadian hockey history.
My favorite thing is getting Spider-Buggy into the film. Because it's so weird and doesn't make any sense.
Metro came in to do a cameo, and he gets a huge laugh.
There's nowhere to run. My bad, everybody. There was somewhere to run.
The shelf above Miles' desk is the little moose from the Mitchells versus the Machines. In Margot's room, you see here the Flindislinifer from Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs.
Our buddies, the Daniels, made the Oscar-winning film Everything Everywhere All at Once, which features a bagel. This film, coincidentally, also features bagels. We needed a billboard, so we thought it would be a billboard for the
Tony Award-winning musical All of It Always All Over the Place.
In Miles' room, all the posters have slightly altered pop culture references for his dimension.
We got the Beastie Girls.
Yeah, we got Wu-Tang Clan.
In Miles' journal, Uncle Aaron's wearing a 3-Pac shirt as opposed to a 2-Pac shirt.
There's an oyster cart, real mother shuckers, and that's actually a real oyster cart. Miles' jersey is a Brooklyn Knicks God Sham God jersey. He was like a playground legend. He didn't have much of a pro career. So in Miles' world, God Sham God became a Knicks player and became one of the all-time greats up there with Jordan.
What?
Ooh, okay.
Miles.
When Rio snaps her fingers, a little Puerto Rican flag pops up.
In this Jeopardy scene, all the categories are spider-themed. Right past the flan, that is a Jell-O mold from Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs. Two posters in Margot's bedroom here, and they're both written in binary code, and one says, anyone can wear the mask, and the other says, let's do this one last time.
When Spot goes into the Venom portal here, you'll notice the mints that he steals are Venom mints by Brock's Candies.
In the Momatin sequence, I stuck in my girlfriend's picture on a billboard.
Are those my Jordans?
I can't help it if we're the same size.
Ganke is playing the Insomniac Spider-Man 2 video game.
When Rio picks up Gwen's sweater, one of the patches on that says Boominati. That is Metro Boomin's label.
The automatopoeia in Pavithra's dimension are translated into Indian dialects instead of crash or bang or boom.
We actually use Fwiz as Miguel O'Hara's web instead of Thwip.
The Thwang effect here is pulled from Web Slinger's comic. When Miguel refers to ASM 90, he's actually referring to Amazing Spider-Man issue 90. The pose you see is Spider-Man holding George Stacy that we saw in the comic.
Event ASM 90, a police captain close to Spider-Man dies.
This original Spider-Man 2099 comic cover, this is a recreation by Rick Leonardi himself.
I got to design a suit for Miguel O'Hara, his white second suit. Miguel's workshop had that design sitting in the background.
The back of Hobie's jacket says FNSM, as well as on his guitar pick, that stands for Friendly Neighborhood Spider-Man. Mugshot here, taken in Camden, London, where Daniel Kaluuya, who voices Hobie, is from, and the founding location of the punk rock movement.
I don't follow orders, neither does he.